Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week we're in Northern California for Collins Lake Rainbows and Sacramento River Striped Bass. Now, if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television.
In the foothills northeast of Yuba City, California, you'll find Collins Lake, a 1,000-acre impoundment stocked full of quality rainbows. Today we're with Ray Thurford, who's fishing with guide Rod Pyatt.
Yeah, we're out here at Collins Lake today. We're looking for some trout. See what we can do, trying out some Neil's Masters. Catch us some big old trout.
Pretty much, we've been catching them all along this rock bank here. What's happening is it's a pretty steep drop off, and then it comes out onto a big flat. And they're sitting on top, feeding within the top 10 foot of the water column. And they're hitting anything from Rapalas to wedding rings to spinners. We were throwing MEP spinners up here a week or two ago. Even my buddy was up here the other day and he was catching them on rattle traps bass fishing. The fish are really aggressive right now. The water temp's 58 degrees. They do frequent trophy plants up here, even smaller, your 8 to 10 inch trout. It's been a hot bite. So
a hot setup. They were a little closer into the bank. We came in here and we didn't go very far. Bam, fish on. Oh yeah, nice fish. There he is. That's what you can expect. He's off. That's what you can expect right there. We catch all these we want, so we're just gonna throw it back, put them back in for the kids, let the kids have some fun with the little guy. But we're running that was caught on a wedding ring and a little worm. You'll see a lot of guys running these old flashers. It causes all kinds of commotion down there, but little wedding ring or pink worm. Just kind of with a little egg weight on it though, so. Trying a little everything today, see what they want. But anyways, that'll work. So we'll go back and see if we can't get a few more. Okay, we got some planer boards out. Justin brought them and we put them way off the side. So we're getting a big spread. So when we're coming through, we're watching the fish come up to the top and pop around the boat. So we're gonna see if we can get bit with farther away from the noise of the motor. See if that's, you know, an advantage or not. So, and we're also covering more water, obviously, so we're gonna try that and see if that will work. But if you see it goes, man, way out there. It's really cool. You can use it for a lot of different things, but today we're gonna try it on these trout. They say bite turns on when the sun comes up, so we'll see what the day brings. It's gonna be hot today, 84. We got 58.7 degree water right now. You know, I like first light, but that wasn't really happening because we were here. But they say the sun comes up, these trout come alive in this lake, so here we go.
We got a fish on here. We got one on the planer board. Nice fish, trolling up top, a couple miles an hour, like we said. Whacked it real hard, man.
That was cool because it was outside. It was outside the way outside, and we're trying the planer boards. First time I've used them, and they're working. Now we just gotta figure out what. There he goes. Yeah, he popped it up.
Fish is on top, headed our way.
That planer board's taking off too. Oh yeah, there he is. Nice one.
Nice fish.
I'll get the pliers. One, two, one.
You want the net, Rich?
No, we're not gonna keep any today. I don't want to net these guys. Just bring him right over here and I'll hunt and hook him. Wow, look at this. Look at this one.
Beautiful fish.
Yeah. Beauty. We'll let the kids have him. It's a gorgeous fish.
Can't see, it's a little worn, but Procure Trophy Trout, it's my go-to up here. It's pretty much all I stick to. Fish love it here. We're putting our gear back out. We're gonna run it at about 50 foot. The back rod's at about 70. And then once we get set up, we're gonna put the planer board back on and get back to fishing. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take this dual lock swivel, take our main line here, run it back through, clip that guy on, and then this guy here, get a nice little bow in our line, right in the back. And then we're gonna let this out. I had this out at another additional 50 foot. Here we go. We're gonna let it out another 50 foot. That's gonna get 50 more feet away from the boat. As you can see, it's gradually getting away from the boat. Nice and easy. And mind you, while we're letting this out, we're still fishing. Another 30 more feet, set the jet.
Welcome back to Collins Lake. I'm Justin Wolf. We deployed the side planers to extend our spread, which has worked out well.
We're catching some fish up top, but as the sun comes up, fish are gonna start moving down a little bit farther. They're still gonna be within the top 10 foot, and later in the day, they'll start coming back up again towards the evening. But for now, we're gonna try this guy right here. Get this rod. Oh, fish on!
While those guys are messing around, I'll reel me one in. I bring the fly rods. I like them. I still use Nils Masters and different lures to just tie it on your line. And but you just get to fight the fish out on a fly rod.
They lost him.
Oh, he's on the surface. That's a nice fish. Look at him tail.
Oh, it's a big one. Woo! You know, I'm known to catch big trout up here. Like 10 years ago, we filmed a show and we got a nice one. It was 7-pounder. And I think we might have a deep. It's a big one. He's heavy.
Coming up.
Whoa,
nice.
He's heavy. Fish.
Oh, wow.
What a tank. What a tank. Oh! Look at the size of that. Oh, wow. Thank you, Collins Lake. Woo! Man, that is a beautiful fish. Oh, he's not quite ready. Man, oh man. Look at the size of that fish. Robbie, let's tail him. Grab him by the tail. And let's get a nice picture in the sun. That's a nice fish. Beautiful fish. Got beautiful spots and all that. We're going to let it back. Kids, here's one for you. Ice cream.
Did he come off?
Oh, he came off.
Came to the surface with it and just going crazy.
A lot of times, because we'll lose a lot of these, you take the back hook off. And you put a single hook. For trout, it works really well. It's probably better than if you're just running a treble hook. I have more luck with single, but we didn't take the hook off, but that happens a lot. They re-bite and re-bite and they work it out. So there's a tip for you guys. If you run a single hook will help you land more fish.
So we're using this particular color because it matches the pattern of the shad that are in this lake.
Okay, that fish come off. We didn't have a hold of our rod. It was in the rod holder. It went wild out there. It was jumping out of the water and spinning and whatnot. But I'm gonna hold the rod now. That way we'll have more out to be able to go up with the fish and back down and land your fish. So keep it out of the rod holder. Should always hold your rod.
We got it about right where we want her now. So here we go.
Okay. He just grabbed it. I was holding the rod that time and I felt him, so hopefully we can keep him on. Not a very big guy. Man, he grabbed it good. That way you don't. It's the oil. You can use the gel. Gel stays on a little better, but there it is. Don't tell nobody.
Fish on.
Hey, that I picked that color out. It's a little tiger stripe one. Okay. Perch pattern tiger stripe. I looked at that and it was a gimme. You could tell it was gonna work. Yeah, we were really impressed with these lures. They got a great lip on them. And we're not saying it to say it. We're saying it because they're catching fish. And we were looking at the colors. We were looking at the colors and the lip, and this little guy, it just looked like, you know, it's a fish catcher. Little perch pattern. And so, and it's doing its job. We just put it out there.
We've had a fun morning with trout, but now we'll drive west to the Sacramento River past the Sutter Buttes.
So everybody that lives around the Sutter Buttes, whether you're in Live Oak or Yuba City or Gridley, whenever you go on a long trip away from home and you're gone a long time, you always know you're home as soon as you can see the buttes. So as soon as you see the buttes in the skyline, you go, man, I'm getting close to home. And they say it's the smallest mountain range in the world. Now, whether it is or isn't, but there is missile silos back there from way back when the wars were going on. They built these silos in there. Kids did a YouTube on it. It was really cool. You could see everything in there. But smallest mountain range in the world, all privately owned. Sutter Buttes.
We've met up with Ryan Tripp for some evening time Sacramento River striped bass.
Well, we came here because there's some fast water, a gravel bar. So we're going to fish that. There should be minnows coming through there. It's a great spot. So we'll work that over with a jerk bait. Right now I'm letting line out because I just spooled up my spool. So that's why we came way down river, though. There's a special spot down here that we like. So we'll hit that. It should be a good one. I'm doing this because when you have braid and you put a new spool of line on, you got to let it out and you reel it back in wet. And it'll get good memory and it'll cast better and it won't get pinched down in your spool. Now don't get snagged, so you're gonna put your thumb on and keep your lure on top of the water or your sinker. Otherwise you can get snagged, and then when you reel it back in, it'll reel back in real nice. Then you'll be able to cast, and when the fish grab it and it takes off, it won't pinch down in your spool. Real important.
We're gonna start off with some jerk baits right here before we get into low light and see if we can get, kind of imitate these salmon smolts coming down. Pretty much just any white lure like this, it twitches and wiggles. This one's by Spro. It's been working pretty good. It's all chewed up, as you can see. We're gonna see if we can get a couple more. They're already starting to pop down here below us.
I got a white jerkbait on. Same thing. We're gonna imitate the smolt coming through, and we're gonna do it real erratic. So the fish see it, and when they see something that's not swimming right, it triggers the bite. They'll come up from deep water. We got real low, clean water. And you want to one, two, pause, one, two, two. And you can change it up a little bit, but you definitely want to give it a couple tugs and let it sit. And then, bam. That thing, you can really see it darting around in there.
So these fish like sitting right here on the front side of this island because it's right in the main slick of the current, big bend of the river up here. So they know those smolts are going to be funneled right to them. So they just sit there and wait instead of wasting their own energy and chasing them down. Oh, yeah. Finally got one. There's some smolts crowd up over there. They were by there at that little spro. Oh, it feels pretty good. Fun on light tackle. Little lures. Fish put up a good fight. That's a nice keeper. Oh yeah. Nice bass. All right. We went right to where we thought they were gonna be. There's a little back eddy over there and the smolts coming down in the current. Kind of get trapped and funneled in there, and those bass know it. There's one sitting right where we thought he should have been. It's a nice keeper. Keeping any? We're gonna let this sucker go. Nice one.
really tough year. We have no water this year, and we've had great water in the last 4 years, and we caught so many fish that I watched the decline in the bass, huge decline in them. You know, there's some guys that will say, oh no, but we're here every day. We fish all year long. And there's just not a lot of bass left, especially keepers. There's a bunch of little guys, but you know, we kept all the 18 to they're keeping them 30, 40 pounds. People are keeping them. We throw all of our fish back, anything over 7-8 pounds, male, female, we throw them back. We like them just, you know, 18 inches that, but it's a bad year, no water, not a lot of fish to be caught. There's just not a lot of numbers, in my opinion, but it's gonna be a tough year. The guys are even fishing live bait, 3 fish a day, some of them. You know, a guy today, one of the best guides out here, he got three keepers today on live bait for all day. And you know, you can come out, you're always gonna be able to catch a few, but the days when you come out caught 100 every day, they're over for a while. Till we get something changes, different conditions in the river or the ocean or whatever it is, the bait, maybe there's not enough bait out there, but it's gonna be a really tough year for a lot of people, including me. So we got our work cut out for us this year.
Back to the Sacramento River. I'm Justin Wolf. We have low water and low numbers of fish in the river, but there's still some fish to be had on Spro jerkbaits and black plastic worms. The sun's about to set, so Wraith and Tim will anchor up.
The sun's just setting down here, and we're just anchored up on a really good feeding spot. We're gonna see if these fish start coming up in the shallows and feeding right at low light on these little salmon smolt. We're just gonna wait them out, try to get them. Oh yeah. I got a bite on a worm.
Yeah, it's the first striper on a worm I've gotten in a year since last year. Ryan, he hears it back there in the motor. Ooh, did you see that?
Ooh.
Did he fin it?
He's spiking you.
I think he spiked me. Well, what happened was the fish rolled and his back spikes are up like that and it hooked the line. Man, good fish.
Fighter.
You know what I need? Hey, Mick, I need my cushion. I'm getting older, man. I want a little pad right here.
Nice one.
We like a small rod so you can feel the bite. You got to be quick on the bite. Which I really wasn't that time. But I like a 6'6" rod, 7 foot, somewhere in there. We don't want a rod that's real long. It's just real hard to feel the bite. And with one hook, you lose these fish all the time because you only got one hook and the mouth's hard as a rock. God, these fish are fighting good. Ooh,
that guy.
Chunk. Not the biggest fish in the world.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Nice one.
Job, kid.
Boom.
I got a good guide here.
Probably a little hand.
It's a male. It's a male, but that's bigger than what I like to eat. We only like them 18 inches. After they get so big, it's good breeder fish too, perfect breeder. Give them a little water and let them go. I mean, he's lively, but man, those big fish, you could slice them down thin and make them taste good, but put enough batter on them. But I like the little guys and I want them to spawn. Male or female, we got to let them go. There's not a lot of fish left, guys. I mean, there's not a lot of fish. People are going to realize this year. There's not a lot of fish. We caught so many the last 4 years. The bay was amazing. The rivers were amazing. There's not a lot of fish left. So with that being said, if we don't put some back, then, you know, we're going to deplete them where there's next to none. We'll always catch some. There's plenty of small little guys that weren't keepers last year. But there's the numbers have gone way down. If we're out here every day like we are, we know when there's a lot of fish. And if I want to eat one, I'll eat. I don't freeze them. I come out here, I catch one, I take it home, and I eat it the next day. So, all right, guys, let's go catch another one. This is a black Gedo ringer. They quit making them. We're gonna find somebody to make us one. They don't make them anymore. They lost the mold. We got about a 3/4 ounce weight and P line. I think this has got to be about 50 pound. Teamed up with a 7-foot rod, Corrado reel. You know, so Daiwa makes really good reels. Whatever you're comfortable with. This just happens to be on what I've always used on this rod particular. But anyways, yeah, we got, that's all you need. We've been doing it for years. Same old, same old. There went another big one out there. God, this one hit it like a train. April 2nd? Look at, this thing hit it like a train. Ooh, he just spiked it. Finally stopped him. Oh, God, he crushed it. All right, boom. Hey, Ryan, can you land my fish again? Will you lip him one? It's close. God, I can't even do nothing with him. I'm gonna have to pull the anchor.
How far are you out here?
Nah, these things fight so hard here because of the current. But it's a big fish. It's a good one. God, I mean, like, I'm leaning on him. Nothing. You know, we're going to design another rod because catching these bigger fish, I need just another couple inches on that butt. Oh, got to be in a tree. Oh, he's got me in a tree. You got to be kidding.
He's got me in a tree.
We're getting him out.
We're gonna throw the anchor and chase back on this thing and try to get below this tree and pull him out the other direction.
God, he found a tree. Stripers always do that. Big fish always find a tree. Man, I'm not feeling nothing but the tree. God, there's never a tree here.
There's not a tree.
Oh, there he goes. I got him out. I'm in a tree. Oh, man. Man, nothing you can do. You know, you win some, lose some. I lose real big fish all the time to trees. I mean, that's, stripers know. That,
where they live.
Yeah, I mean, that's where they live. So, hey, we'll get another one.
I hope you enjoyed today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, there would be no show. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.